According to the Elgon Regional Police spokesperson, Superintendent Roger Staitika, those arrested are part of a big group that police is currently hunting down. He says the hunt for such gangs is on, with the help of local council chairpersons, chief administrative officers, and DPCs across the country.
Era nkakasa nti wiki eno balina okulabika nga basimbwa mu mbuga z'amateeka bagende mu maaso n'okuvunaanibwa omusango oguli okukwata ebintu oba okufojaringa.
It is believed that when the gang members identify their target, they make documents in that person's name and identification cards, as well as letters of recommendation to a bank and bank statements, and issue fake documents. They later persuade the victim to pay off loans that they are clueless about. In the event, they threaten with arrests, since they also have fake stamps from high offices, and they sometimes use officers to carry out the robberies, as Superintendent Roger Staitika explains.
Particulars over CVO muntu nadalanga ali wa government obe kitongole ekikukutivu ne bagiranga baziraga mbitongole ebenja ule bigaba sent.
The gangs also infiltrate banks through technology and withdraw money from people's accounts, leaving banks in huge debts. Taitika explains the incident from Dark Hill Microfinance, where a case of forgery, theft and impersonation was registered.
Bana olwalero tusobodde bafuna nga balina engeri gye babudisaamu abakungu ba Dark Hill Financial Institution wano mu kibuga Mbale, nga balina engeri gye bagizemu particulars z'omu agambibwa okubeera nti musirikale waffe, of course.
Police have cautioned banks and moneylenders to be keen and cautious while analyzing documents of those who wish to
borrow.
The criminal gangs in Imbale have terrorized mobile money agents, banks, money lenders, and have issued threats to a number of people, and murders have been reported. Report compiled by Faizo Chiza for the news.